"The States mean well," moaned Cousin Sophia, "but all the vim in the world cannot put them on the fighting line this spring, and the Allies will be finished before that. The Germans are just luring them on. That man Simmons says their retreat has put the Allies in a hole."
"That man Simmons has said more than he will ever live to make good," retorted Susan. "I do not worry myself about his opinion as long as Lloyd George is Premier of England. He will not be bamboozled, and that you may tie to. Things look good to me. The U.S. is in the war, and we have got Kut and Baghdad back. And I would not be surprised to see the Allies in Berlin by June, and the Russians, too, since they have got rid of the Tsar. That, in my opinion, was a good piece of work."
"Time will show if it is," said Cousin Sophia, who would have been very indignant if any one had told her that she would rather see Susan put to shame as a seer than a successful overthrow of tyranny, or even the march of the Allies down Unter den Linden. But then the woes of the Russian people were quite unknown to Cousin Sophia, while this aggravating, optimistic Susan was an ever-present thorn in her side. Just at that moment Shirley was sitting on the edge of the table in the living-room, swinging his legs, a brown, ruddy, wholesome lad from top to toe, every inch of him, and saying coolly, "Mother and Dad, I was 18 last Monday. Don't you think it's about time I joined up?" The pale mother looked at him. "Two of my sons have gone, and one will never return. Must I give you two, Shirley?" The age-old cry, "Joseph is not, and Simeon is not, and you will take Benjamin away." How the mothers of the Great War echoed the old patriarch's moan of so many centuries agone. "You wouldn't have me a slacker, mother. I can get into the Flying Corps. What say, Dad?" The doctor's hands were not quite steady as he folded up the powders he was concocting for Abby Flagg's rheumatism. He had known this moment was coming, yet he was not altogether prepared for it. He answered slowly, "I won't try to hold you back from what you believe to be your duty. But you must not go unless your mother says you may."